Costa Rica, a tropical paradise. Soothing winds, relaxing waves, colorful birds, and magical moments. A perfect place for a getaway, right?
And I signed up because I'm really big on traveling and I've been to a lot of places in the world, but I've never been to Central America, so I thought going to Costa Rica would be a really cool thing to do.
I signed up because I like to travel. My mom thought it would be a really good idea for me to experience something outside of the country.
I came to Costa Rica to experience life outside of the United States, out of the Bay Area, out of California, out of everything, because Costa Rica is so much different.
Although there's a lot of work involved and not as much free time as I expected, I definitely learned a lot more than I did expect, and I had a great time meeting a lot of new people and having a great time with a lot of other people that I met and made a lot of new friends.
Arriving in Costa Rica, students discovered that it wasn't quite what they expected. They took a bus to the cloud forest where they stayed in a small lodge. It was freezing cold outside and in the rooms. This was their first wake-up call to the real Costa Rica. Students realized that Costa Rica wasn't just a pretty place in a fancy brochure. The students learned that there is more to Costa Rica than its beautiful beaches. There are endangered animals, plants, and beautiful snakes. Interesting insects and lizards, and moss-covered trees weathered by ravages of time.
Due to its geographical position and the particular climate where it is located, Costa Rica is one of the most biodiverse countries in the world. Within Costa Rica, the Osa Peninsula is considered one of the focal points of biodiversity, since it contains the last viable populations of several animals in danger of extinction, such as the jaguar, scarlet macaw, tapir, white-lipped peccary, and several more. Even though found in some other places of Central America, they don't have big enough territories to survive.
After leaving the Talamanca Mountains, students went to the Osa Peninsula to stay at Campanario Biological Field Station. Arriving at Campanario in Osa was an experience they won't likely forget. Going from place to place was more than just a change in scenery. It was a journey filled with learning experiences, new discoveries, and surprises. In coming to Costa Rica, students learn that the most remarkable places on Earth are the most threatened, and that these threatened places are called biodiversity hotspots. The richest and the most threatened reservoirs of plant and animal life are in these hotspots. There are 34 of them on Earth. OSA is a key conservation target inside the Greater Mesoamerica Biodiversity Hotspot. The OSA region contains the last tract of contiguous tropical lowland rainforest on the entire Pacific slope of Central America. OSA maintains a richness of life that is unique to the world. Campanario Field Station was set up to help protect OSA's treasures.
Yeah, really.
The group witnessed firsthand the amazing biodiversity Costa Rica has to offer and enjoyed a multitude of experiences in the natural world.
see the beach right out there and like everybody here, why wouldn't you want it?
We saw like a bunch of different animals that I never even knew existed really, except for when we came here, like spider monkeys and howler monkeys, which sound kind of creepy. And I learned a bunch of like different things about like things you can eat in the forest, like if you're ever lost, like water vines or like the berries of the mellowstone leaf, which you can eat and stuff like that. So yeah, I learned a bunch of cool stuff here about nature, yeah.
Or Mariana would teach us something about a particular thing that was going on in the forest, like types of leaves or animals, like spider webs and stuff like that.
Besides hiking, students went to a bat cave and caught bats for scientific measuring and study. They ate termites, studied leaves, and grew fascinated by sloths and other wildlife native to Costa Rica. Students especially enjoyed watching monkeys swing from treetop to treetop in the Costa Rican rainforest. They also enjoyed swimming in waterfalls and in the ocean surf. A campanario, cables and platforms were hung in the rainforest canopy to assist students and scientists in observing the rainforest more intimately. No trees, no vines were damaged or cut down in the whole system. Traveling through the rainforest on cables and platforms gave the students new perspective on the canopy and how trees are host to so many plants and animals. The rainforest is an intricate, entirely intertwined ecosystem. If one thing falls out, then everything falls out. That's why it's so threatened. Everything is so connected. Being connected is something that took on new meaning for the students. They began to understand that, like ecosystems they learned about, they too were connected through interdependence.
You kind of just get to know each other better and hear some of the ideas and the opinions that people have and like grow stronger together as like a family kind of thing.
By sharing new experiences and overcoming hardships, the students grew.
I am really nervous.
They sweated together, hiked, swam and snorkeled together, ate together, and learned to overcome fears together, like bugs, the dark, and heights. Through it all, they bonded.
My favorite thing about coming here is watching each student grow in a new way. It's always an individual thing, but I see them come away with a better understanding of themselves and an understanding of the world in a way that they never would have gotten if they were at home.
Before I came here, I thought like my cell phone was always attached to me and I always had to look at it for the time and I'd check it every 5 minutes to see if I had a new text message or a new call or anything like that. And like when I came here and I didn't have that, I realized I could relax more and I wasn't worried about checking my cell phone every 5 minutes or like just running around trying to figure stuff out, and I'm able to breathe and think about nature and just be in the beauty of it and realize what I missed when I was at home with my cell phone.
When I go home from school, I get on the computer. When I have my phone on all day, I'm texting people a lot. Like, and I thought that I would like be like totally wanting my phone the whole time when I came here, but I've learned that I don't need it all the time. Like, I came here, I haven't really thought about it, like, once. Like, I'd rather see a monkey swinging 30 feet in the air than texting someone.
Students learned many things, including that sometimes trees fall naturally in the rainforest and that people can benefit from these situations. Students also learned about forest succession and how it takes a long time for a forest to grow back after its trees have been cut down or burned. Learning about forest succession helps students understand why change needs to happen now, not later. In the few days they have been at Campanario, students have learned that the world won't change if people don't change.
Costa Rica is one of the most biodiverse countries in the world, and its biodiversity is highly regarded. Habitat destruction becomes one of its greatest threats, and basically from human occupation for farms, logging, mining, and now the latest wave, at least in the Osa Peninsula, is to construct, develop, invade, if you will, these habitats to build vacation homes, to build shopping malls. And Project Campanario's work in this whole thing is to save a piece of that, to leave it in its natural state, and also then to educate the youth so they can continue work.
It's curious how people don't question our need to protect our cultural and historical legacy. In this case, we're talking about our biological heritage. And it is something that has millions of years of existence and by itself should be worthy enough for conservation.
The trip to Costa Rica has helped students fully understand that it is actually possible to take action to stop environmental destruction. It's not a fairy tale. Everyone can make a difference and help solve the problems that face us all. An action can be as simple as not buying bottled water, using a